So did you see that?
Hi, my name is Sachit. I'm studying in grade 3. My school name is BRS Global School. So today I'm going to explain about Scratch. Scratch is a block-based program. There are so many projects in Scratch. I am going to explain you about 3 projects. The first one is It's Me Sprite, and the second one is adding a backdrop, and the third one is start moving. Before It's Me Sprite, I want to tell you something. We can create games, play games, and animate in Scratch. Now let's see It's Me Sprite. The sprite is the characters in Scratch. So now I'm going to tell you how to go to a sprite library. So to go to a sprite library, you should click this button or this magnifying glass button. So now I'm going to click that. I'll get so many options of sprites. Now I'm going to choose my favorite sprite. The sprite appeared in the screen. Now if you want to delete the sprite, you should click on the sprite in the screen. So you will get the delete option right here. So if you click on that, the sprite will be deleted. So now we are going to see how to resize a sprite, how to change the direction of the sprite, and how to duplicate a sprite. To change the size of sprite, we should press this button, and whatever size you want, you can type it in the keyboard and put it. So I changed it into 50 and it became small. So again, I'm going to change it into 100. To change the direction of sprite, you should move thing which is right here, and you can change the direction of sprite. So to duplicate a sprite, you should right click the sprite on the screen. You will get some options. In that, if you press duplicate, you will get the sprite again. So now again, if you want to delete it, you can delete it. Now we finish It's Me Sprite. Now let's move on to adding a backdrop. To add a backdrop, we should press this button or this magnifying glass button. So I'm going to press that. So you'll get so many options of the backdrop. I'm going to choose my favorite backdrop. So the backdrop appears right here. So now I'm going to show how to delete a backdrop. So to delete a backdrop, you should press the backdrop right here. And here you'll get the word backdrop. So if you press on that, you'll get all the backdrops which you did not delete. If the backdrop is not nice in the screen, you can try pressing the delete option above the backdrop. So I'm going to press the delete option. So now it changed. The backdrop changed. So we finished the project called backdrop. Now we are going to move to the project called start moving. To move to the project called start moving, first you should scroll up and you should press this button. And you should fully go backside and type start moving. Now I type start moving. So you can move the sprite wherever you want. So now I'm going to show you some things how to move the sprite. So first, if you press this and if you keep it here, whatever you want, you can choose it next. So if you want to make the sprite move 10 steps, you can keep it here. So it's written when flag click. So if you press this, it will move 10 steps. So I'm going to press the flag button. So it started moving. So now I'm going to show how to make the sprite move left and right. So first you should go to the events block and you should take this one 2 times and keep it like this. Next you should go to the motion block and take move 10 steps, that also 2 times. So to move, press here, make it into left arrow, and you should press here and make it into right arrow. But if you want to move it in the left, you should make it into minus 10. So I'm going to make it into minus 10. so it became into minus 10. Because I wrote left arrow and right arrow, I should plus the left arrow and right arrow. So I'm going to press it. So did you see that? Now I'm going to show some things in the scratch movement. So now if you, again you should go to this and take this and go to control block and make it and take repeat 10. Now you should go to motion block, glide 1 second to random position. So if you press that, and again if you press this, because it's written when flag clicked here, so if you press this, it will start going glide 1 second to random position. So now it's stopped. This is for stop button and this is for start button.